next song is called Sondela. And I hope you guys are having a good time and keeping safe at home. Enjoy Africa Day. Thank you. Celebrating our beautiful continent, beautiful cultures, beautiful story, and happy Africa Day, everyone.
Contributed in the province because athletics is broad, and as Nelson Mandela said, sports brings people together. So in athletics we meet people from all over the world, all over Africa, and we become one, and we share ideas as well, and training programs and our diets, and especially the Kenyans, because they are the fastest, and the Ethiopians. So I think that has brought us more together than being competitors. There's nothing like home, like South Africa. But traveling around Africa has been life-changing in a way that...
Thank you again. I hope you have an incredible celebrating our beautiful continent, beautiful cultures, beautiful story, and happy Africa Day, everyone.
Certain place in Africa and see that it's different, you enjoy it, you Kenya is different, Namibia is different, so I don't know, it's just amazing to be around different individuals, different cultures, especially in Africa, because in South Africa we are one, we know all the cultures in South Africa, but in Africa it's totally different cultures and different personalities, different people, different languages altogether than the ones that we know in South Africa. So it has been an amazing journey in learning more about my fellow Africans. We had the first World Cup in Africa, where we hosted the 2010 Soccer World Cup. We are bidding for Olympics. We are building for other major sporting codes. I'm talking in a sports perspective because I'm an athlete, so I know the progress that Africa has made. Kenya recently hosted the World Junior Championships. So Africa is going in the right direction in terms of developing the structures of sports as well, because we have seen Africa as we must go to Europe to host big tournaments. So Africa is now bidding with the first world countries. So we must be proud of that as African, especially the sports fraternity should be proud of how far Africa has come in terms of that. For Africa to progress, we need new minds, we need fresh minds, we need young people to help us go forward. We must invest in education as well in Africa. We must invest in new sporting facilities. I think we must go back to the grassroots for Africa to progress, because if I as an athlete retires, who else is gonna take over? If another person, when the Rugby World Cup winners retire, who's going to take over? So development is more important for us to go forward. It has been a major downfall, personally and in Africa as well, because as much as we run in South Africa or in Africa, most races were cancelled, not even postponed. The biggest races, like in South Africa, your Two Oceans Marathons, your Comrade Marathons have been cancelled. So before this is my passion, running is my passion, but it's also my livelihood. So it has been difficult, and I don't know how far is it gonna be, because most races now are being cancelled to the end of the year. And if I feel for our African athletes as well, your Kenyans, Ethiopians, Nigerians, because we, right now, I think we would be in Europe for the European season preparing for the Olympics, and we're not gonna have Olympics this year. You plan for something, and this pandemic has put everything to stop in a way, and financially as well, it's it's difficult for some people, is most people, most athletes, most best personalities, as they are livelihood, so life is not normal, and some people is from hand to mouth, so there are certain things that have stopped in their lives through this pandemic, and I hope when everything falls into place, people will be more motivated to do better than they have been. What makes me proudly South African? South Africa is home. Not because I was born in South Africa, I'm a South African at heart. So the diversity in South Africa, and I grew up in the township, I'm a bit old. So at that time, they've always said it takes a village to raise a child. And I think those are the principles that the youth must carry with them. It makes me proud of the principles of Ubuntu in South Africa, that respect is mutual, you know, you cannot let your neighbor suffer while you have. So being a South African is more a hard thing than a physical thing, that I was born in South Africa, and reading about our history and where we come from as a country, it makes me proud to be a South African. I'm a proudly African, and happy Africa Day.
Over gentle waters, help me follow my stream in this ocean of life. Fish coming in different species, another one of life's lessons, and at times my blessings seem few and far between. All these politics I'm sandwiched in between, yet the twins good and bad never cease to exist. My eyes are salty from the fear of swimming alone, though heroes are born in adversity. My heart skips a beat. My heart skips a beat. My heart skips a beat. For what it's worth, I thought I should write you this letter. Maybe it might make me feel a bit better than this ball of destruction you were busy constructing in my mind, while all the while I thought you were kind. And yet I feel it again, this discomfort, this could it be you that is bringing the breakdown and the showdown of the rising of this queen? With rains of infinite passion, you drowned me in just after the lesson on how I could be a better person. My heart skips a beat. My heart skips a beat. My heart skips a beat, and it's telling me, Rongo. I, Rongo. I, Sana Rongo.
This is Dr. Abdul Karim El Goni. I am the chairman of the African Diaspora Forum. This is an organization of the collective of 33 African diaspora associations in South Africa, as well as Pakistan and Bangladesh, who are working together to support the South African governments in holding the rights of refugees and asylum seekers, and to integrate those migrants into the South African community. The African Diaspora Forum is an organization that was formed in 2008 in response to the bad xenophobic attacks that happened in that year, the conflict that happens between migrants and the South African community. And all those organizations came together in 2008 and formed this organization to try and work together to reduce xenophobia and to create integration between all those communities and the South Africans, and at the same time to assist those migrants working together in their local communities, in the policing forums and other community works, to integrate with the needs of the communities at local level. In this Africa Day, we used to celebrate it extensively, especially in Johannesburg, but this year we have to do a virtual celebration. So I will salute you all with an Africa Day salute, and I will say Eid Mubarak, because today for Muslims it is the day of Eid in South Africa, wishing you prosperity, health and safety from the coronavirus. The I am just one of 50 African leaders who are working together in the African Diaspora Forum to create and implement the objectives of the African Diaspora Forum, that is to integrate migrants and asylum seekers into the South African community and see how can we contribute to the African development. As you know, this Africa Day is a response to the meeting of six African countries in 1958 in Ghana. Six countries, six independent countries were together in Ghana, plus two almost independent countries. I am happy that my country, Sudan, is one of those six independent countries at that time. There were three in the north, two in East Africa, which is Sudan and Ethiopia, and two in West Africa, Ghana and Liberia. In our work as a diaspora, we are putting our strength of skills, scholarships, and spirits into developing Africa, and specifically into developing South Africa. There are so many migrants who are teachers in South Africa, assisting with education. There are so many doctors and nurses who are assisting with the health of people. Coronavirus has shown us that there is no difference between a migrant, asylum seeker, and a South African. We are all together in one context, and we have to live life collectively. I am really very proud of many spaza shop owners who have stood up and gave the Africa Diaspora Forum hundreds of thousands of rands of commodities that we have distributed in so many places, from Cape Town to Bloemfontein to Durban to Gauteng. It was really satisfying to see those people who are working on a day-to-day basis and to be that generous and give us all this. I'm really also proud of the Africa diaspora leaders who were there during the lockdown, going house to house, distributing food hampers. We have done a lot, but unfortunately, the problem is highly bigger than the African Diaspora Forum. Although we have distributed thousands of food hampers and gave money to some people to prevent their evacuation from homes, but still there are thousands who are hungry. I was really moved when thousands of emails and WhatsApp messages came to me, the majority of them using the word, "We are hungry, help." And I find myself and my other leaders unable to help everyone. We urge the South African government to do more and not to discriminate against migrants and asylum seekers. We felt really unhappy when at the beginning of COVID-19 lockdown that one minister of the government have discriminated against migrants and prevented the spaza shops owned by non-South Africans to close during the lockdown, although the services that we are providing are really very important for those communities, as we are helping them not to go out and look for transport, which is not possible. For me as a Sudanese South African, my experience working as a doctor and health consultant in many African countries, in Botswana, Lesotho, Namibia, and Zimbabwe and other countries, I really appreciate that people have taken me with open arms and helped me to share my little experience in health management and try to improve the health services in those countries. As I am talking now, I am working in Lesotho, a democratic country that has just elected a new prime minister that we have a lot of hope in him to make things better in Lesotho, create jobs for especially the youth, and you and tap on the resources of Lesotho, especially agriculture, and make Lesotho self-sufficient. I am really feeling a proud African, because although I am coming from the east of Africa, from the Horn of Africa, and coming and residing in South Africa, I don't see any difference. I am living with my family, with my neighbors, with my co-workers. There is no discrimination. They see me as one African like them, which fills the heart with joy. In closing, I would like to say the African Diaspora Forum is trying its best to assist the Africans and the asylum seekers who are living in dire need in different parts of South Africa. We wish that everyone who is able to look to their neighbors and give them something, even a bread, will be a big difference to people. People are in need. So please look around you and see if you can contribute even the smallest that you can. In closing, I want to say I am a proud African and I salute you. Thank you.
Swahibu Varisu. I'm the executive director of the African World Heritage Fund. I'm from Benin myself, and I'll be talking on the topic of culture and heritage within the African Month celebration. I'll just give an overview of what's going on the continent. The whole month of May is dedicated to various events to celebrate Africa Month. In other contexts, especially at UNESCO, the 5th of the Africa Month is rather celebrated as Africa Week. And we have, of course, the Africa Day, which is the 25th of May, which is celebrated all over the continent, even worldwide. This year, we are really having a quite special celebration because of the constraints that come from the COVID-19 pandemic. All the celebration will be online and virtual. Hence, the quite huge use of online and virtual tools like Instagram, Microsoft Teams, and Zoom, and others. You might know that the Africa Day, which is the 25th of May, is the date where the Organization of African Unity was created in 1963 in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. So it's in remembrance of that birthday of our continental body that then was replaced by the African Union in 2002, that the 25th of May has been dedicated to celebrate Africa and Africa Union. That's why we call it Africa Day. The Africa Day itself, 25th of May, is strongly rooted in a strategic document that we call Agenda 2063, the Africa we want. It's a strategic document that was developed and adopted by the AU Assembly, the Head of State Summit, in 2005. And in 2015. And that document, which projects our aspiration as Africans in the next 50 years, it is rooted in a number of aspirations. We have 7 aspirations, and some of those aspirations are talking strongly to culture and heritage as an angle of a given value and, you know, profile our continent on the global arena. I think it's extremely important to note that in the Agenda 2063, the Africa we want, the whole purpose is to redefine ourselves as Africans, as a community living on the continent and outside the continent, that is working towards a vision, the vision of an integrated, prosperous, and peaceful Africa, driven by its own people, its own citizens, and representing a dynamic force in the international arena. That's one article of the agenda, and it's a quite strong one. As my name is Swahibu Varisu, I'm the executive director of the African World Heritage Fund. I'm from Benin myself, and I'll be talking on the topic of culture and heritage within the Africa Month celebration. I'll just give an overview of what's going on the continent. The whole month of May is dedicated to various events to celebrate Africa Month. In other contexts, especially at UNESCO, the 5th of the Africa Month is rather celebrated as Africa Week. And we have, of course, the Africa Day, which is the 25th of May, which is celebrated all over the continent, even worldwide. This year, we are really having a quite special celebration because of the constraints that come from the COVID-19 pandemic. All the celebration will be online and virtual. Hence the quite huge use of online and virtual tools like Instagram, Microsoft Teams and Zoom and others. You might know that the African Day, Africa Day, which is the 25th of May, is the date where the Organization of African Unity was created in 1963 in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. So it's in remembrance of that birthday of our continental body that then was replaced by the African Union in 2002, that the 25th of May is has been dedicated to celebrate Africa and Africa Union. That's why we call it Africa Day. The Africa Day itself, 25th of May, is strongly rooted in a strategic document that we call Agenda 2063, the Africa we want. It's a strategic document that was developed and adopted by the AU Assembly, the Head of State Summit, in 2005. And in 2015. And that document, which projects our aspiration as Africans in the next 50 years, it is rooted in a number of aspirations. We have 7 aspirations, and some of those aspirations are talking strongly to culture and the heritage as an angle of a given value and, you know, profile our continent on the global arena. I think it's extremely important to note that in the Agenda 2063, the Africa we want, the whole purpose is to redefine ourselves as Africans, as a community living on the continent and outside the continent, that is working towards a vision, the vision of an integrated, prosperous and peaceful Africa, driven by its own people, its own citizens, and representing a dynamic force in the international arena. That's one article of the agenda, and it's a quite strong one.